thanks for joining me, and welcome to another ASMR and beer review, where we're going to take a look at Yuengling Traditional Original Amber Lager. This is owned and brewed right here in my home state of Pennsylvania, up in Pottstown, which is north of Maine, by I'd probably say about 2 hours, a good 2 hours, I think. This is, surprisingly enough, the first time I think that I've reviewed a beer from my home state, and at least, you know, I can't recall how many, I don't really keep track of the beers I review, but I don't think I've done from New York. I think I've done like Maryland to Delaware or something like that. But a couple viewers in the past, not recently, have suggested, you know, asked if I could do a Yuengling review. And, well, figures about right time. So, and I also want to thank the particular viewer from Sweden who had actually asked if, who says he or she enjoys the beer reviews, and it kind of was like, you know, it's been a while since I've done one, so here we are. So we're going to take a look and open, review one of those, and drink one. I've had them already, which is why I really haven't done. I kind of wanted to explore different craft beers that I've never had before, whether domestic or international. So that's really the only reason I've never did it. I also have a sack of peanuts from my Iggy. He said it was okay if I could borrow his sack. I also have zombie tarot cards that I received graciously from a viewer. Thank you again. This was about 2 or 3 months ago. I wasn't sure what to do in this video, you know, ramble, talk, you know, it's always, you know, after the beer review, it's, you know, it's whatever, so, but I thought it'd be kind of interesting. We'll take a look at this. I've never dealt or even looked at this besides the one time I did in that particular video, I forget, and we'll deal a couple hands, and then we'll give this a go, because I actually want to get around to using this in Frank Walker, you know, the zombie, doing a zombie tarot for a zombie customer client. So just real quick, for those of you new to this series, I'm just a regular guy. I these reviews are very modest. I'm not an expert. I'm not looking to become an expert, really. I'm just looking to, enjoy beer, with a friend. And I think it's also for those out there who've never tried craft beer before, it's kind of a way there's never, you know, any, like, real education, so to speak. At least, well, I guess it depends on the household that you grow up, the home you grow up, the school you go to, but, you know, for the most part, you know, it's Coors Light, Miller Light, Bud Light on the TV. And maybe you think, or you know, I at least when I started drinking craft brews, I just didn't know, you know, that there might be a particular stigma you have in your head about craft brews, you know, snobs drink crap, yuppies, whatever, but that's not really the case. I mean, you know, maybe that was the thought back in the 90s or something, I don't know. But if you've never really tried craft beer before, go to a local, try to find a local place. There might be a beer store, could be lots of, could be a supermarket, even certain. Peaches shops starting to carry more craft brews, and while they could be, they usually are a little more, not really, a little more expensive than the commercialized beer. You know, there's just so many to try. It's just something, you know, to try once in a while, or whatever. There's just so many. So, I wanted to say that, and of course, I'm always drink responsibly, so. Alright. Always, I don't want to be that guy, but a lot of folks that maybe don't know how to drink or handle their alcohol, and once you feel the effects, that's pretty much when you should stop. I only drink, really, a couple a week, if that. I don't need it, I do it just to enjoy it once in a while, so. Now, you know, this might be the first beer review of 2015, I think. I know I did those two beer reviews by the fireplace or something like that, I think, back in December. I can't really remember, but, you know, with the new year, I think we have to up the stakes a little bit. You know, we used to do a little beer buddy here. We used to do, what was it, 10 reps, right? I think we got to that to 20. You know, I think we really deserve a more exercise and a better healthy lifestyle, so we're gonna do 10 reps of our beer buddy here. If he's gonna cooperate, I might need to, not cooperating too well. Two. this brew. A nice pour. Some of you folks enjoy the bottle cap sounds. I hope the new year has been treating you well so far. But you know, just learn more about yourself, you know, learning from the past, trying to improve on the present and the future and all that. And reflecting, I think reflection is real important. Not just reflecting on mistakes, but, you know, reflecting on the positive things. You know, on their strengths. It's always good, I think, to think about things. Reflect about, you know, decisions we've made, things we've done. Whether, you know, everything, whether it's good or bad, indifferent. You know, I think it's always good. You first. Some of those solid sounds. It's got a nice amber color. Yeah, the head dissipates fairly well. I'll give that to you. Here you go. And if you don't drink, that's fine. You know what? It looks like a twist. I don't think I needed a bottle cap opener. I'm looking at it now, and it's got a twist to it. Ridge. But I could be wrong. I'm usually always wrong. And since it doesn't really generate much of the head, no, I'm just pouring like that. Small sensor. So I don't know if you have a Yuengling level, you have that one, but if you want to join me, we can do this together. If you really have a Yuengling with you, take a look at the color. I mean, it's got an amber color to it. Hopefully you can see that. Take a nice sniff, and it's got a lot going on. As far as the aroma is concerned, definitely has a hoppy citrus aroma to it. My sniffer has never been the best. I've always had an issue with allergies. Probably because being highly sensitive. Yeah, so, to good health, right? To a happy and safe new year and all that. Cheers. Reaching room temperature. I'm getting a very, man, I don't want to say skunky. No, I'm getting a very grassy taste. It's light. I mean, it's smooth. There's no, it's on the watery side. I'm actually not very impressed with this, and I'm not trying to diss Yuengling at all. I don't know what's three stars. I hate to go less than three stars. That's just my immediate taste. Light. Seems to be a little on the watery side. It doesn't have much of a body feel to it, really. It's not really, I won't say it's not really skunky. Yuengling is it's a nice drink to have with food, because it's not going to fill you up, and it's not too. I've had Yuengling before. I mean, can you get a bad batch? Is that how their beer tastes now? Getting a slightly, like I said, that grassy, borderline skunky undertone. Now, I don't know if this is because I've been drinking porters, stouts, Belgian, you know, wheat beers, white beers, and I've just kind of again, I don't want to diss the company, or especially if you like Yuengling. I definitely don't want to, you know, talk down about it, but I'm just kind of not impressed. I don't know why. It's just very flat. I mean, I'm just kind of disappointed. I kind of was hoping for, it's only been sitting out of the refrigerator for about 3 hours from when I bought it. I mean, so maybe it was sitting too long on the shelf. I don't know. This 3 stars. If you like it, more power to you. But I'm a little disappointed. I've never really had to say this in a beer review before. I've had beers before where I've had Stella Artois, I think that's how you pronounce it. And I don't remember that. You know, that's just the same as this. But yeah, anyway, I don't want to harp on, keep repeating myself and saying it's not bad, but on a scale of good to good, this is a good. It's not bad, but yeah, so anyway. As far as the taste, like I said, it's not much of a body. It's very light. It's got some citrus taste to it. Yeah, so. Alright. That's really going to be that. The beer review. Alright, so we're going to change the camera view, looking down at the table, and check out the zombie tarot cards and maybe nibble on some peanuts. We'll see. Finish drinking up the Yuengling regrettably. So for now, I just want to say thank you for joining me, because we're gonna change the camera position and I'll be the last you see of me, and then we'll just kind of eventually just finish the video as I play with the zombie tarot card deck. So thanks for joining me. Yeah, it was good to see you, and stay tuned as always for more videos and more beer reviews as well. Alright, so see you on the flip side. Alright, welcome to Zombie Tarot. Says insight and ammunition for surviving the undead uprising. Mystical prediction oracle with card deck and instructions. 78 tarot cards. Zombie tarot. In the event of a zombie attack, secure location, open this box and consult the Zombie Tarot. This fully functional 78 card tarot deck offers valuable advice on life, love, family, friendship, automatic firearms, premature burials, cannibalistic children, and more. The enclosed instruction book shows how to interpret all 78 cards and provides helpful tips on giving a reading. Okay, so let's open this up. show's all about the cards, so we'll get to that. And then we have this nice little box, a little felt. There's all the cards. We have this nice little box. This nice like felt material in it. Okay, we don't need that. Put that aside. And here's just a sample of the cards. King of Cups. Looks like a zombie. Sitting in a chair. Just all kinds. Don't really know how to shuffle this yet, but I'll take a look. Okay, let's check out the instructions. Instructions by Stacy Graham. Cards illustrated by Paul Keppel and Ralph Gironi. Head Case Design, Quirk Books, Philadelphia. That's interesting. It's my hometown, pretty much. Copyright 2012, Quirk Productions. Interesting. Quirk Books, 215 Church Street, Philadelphia, PA. Quirkbooks.com. Interesting, interesting. Let's check that out. Contents, the Zombie Tarot, your weapon of choice, conducting a reading, the beginner, and these are all sample readings, the beginner, the broken heart, the gravestone, the eyeball, the severed head, the major arcana, the minor arcana. Zombie Tarot, your weapon of choice, remember when it all began, with that spill of toxic sludge out on Route 195? And those poor motorists complaining of headaches and blurry vision. And then there was that crazy, quote-unquote, homeless person. The one biting all those senior citizens on the subway. Followed by a series of violent encounters at the local hospital. Police and firefighters arrived to lend a hand. Most ended up sacrificing a limb or worse. Things escalated so quickly. Families sought refuge in schools, churches, and government buildings to no avail. Okay. Blah, blah, blah. There's no doubt about it. Life is tough, but when you're out of ammo, and up against the wall, make the Zombie Tarot your weapon of choice. When used properly, these cards can offer advice on a host of situations and a glimpse of the big picture to come. The deck is divided into the Major Arcana, 22 cards that chronicle the fool's journey from his first faltering steps to the end of the world, and the minor arcana, 56 cards that analyze the nitty-gritty of a situation through characters and behavior. Together, these cards reveal a path forward. Should you stay in your fallout shelter until the last of your supplies are depleted? Flee to one of the government-sponsored refugee camps? Proceed directly to the Guns R Us. Consult the Zombie Tarot to determine the best course of action. These cards can't predict the future, but they can offer you much needed perspective on a situation. Pay attention to your intuition, listen to your instincts, and always, always keep the shotgun loaded. Okay, understanding the suits and numbers. The various suits and numbers in the minor arcana are associated with specific traits, behaviors, and tendencies. There is a handy cheat sheet Here is a handy cheat sheet when you need an at-a-glance information. Suiting up cups. These represent emotions, artistic tendencies, sex, and relationships. So this is cups right here. Wands. These represent growth, creativity, career, energy, and achievement. Let's see if I can find a wands in here. Easy enough. I don't know. Okay, I'll look just one more time. Where's the wands? Okay, there we go, there's wands. Swords. These represent intellect, logic, courage, and conflict. Swords. Hazards. These represent material wealth, money, prosperity, and property. Hazards, okay. Alright. So there's the suits. Wands, swords, hazards, and cups. Breaking down the numbers. Aces. These represent impulsive decisions, beginnings, and or the start of a new venture. Twos. These represent relationships, balance, and or decisions. Okay, so it goes through all the different. Okay, conducting a reading. Double check the locks on your door and then get comfortable. Try to relax. Choose your favorite spread from the following options. Focus on your, and here's different spreads. The beginner, the broken heart, the eyeball, the gravestone. Focus on your question and shuffle the cards. As you place the cards in position, see if a pattern emerges. Heavy on the suit of swords, there may be legal issues or conflict dominating your path. Cups, sweet lovin' with a cute zombie slayer may be coming your way. It may sometimes seem that the answers are as muddled as the misfits outside your house licking the windows. When this is the case, try another spread, or use only the major arcana to see if the answers are revealed. If not, clear your mind and try again in a few hours after the latest wave of crazies has wandered off. Okay, the beginner. Never fired a shotgun before. New to the world of the undead. If this is your introduction to the zombie tarot, keep it simple. Okay, so we're gonna do the spread, the beginner. One, two, three. First card represents past, the middle is present, and the third is future. Okay, so let's put this little up here so I can keep it handy a little bit. That's not gonna work because it wants to close up. Okay, we'll just flip it over. So we're gonna shuffle this deck. Not to make too much noise. That's why I'm shuffling terribly. swords. Probably because I didn't shuffle too good. Alright, doesn't matter. Let's have fun. Alright. This card represents your past. The Queen of Swords. So, what was your past? Your past. Now, let's see what the Queen says. All the swords. Your past was full of intellect, logic, courage, and conflict. And the Queen, they represent a real person as opposed to a situation. So in your past, there was someone that was intelligent, logical, courageous, or conflicting. So you knew someone that was either intelligent, that was full of logic. There was logic in your past with this person. Maybe it was a good, if it's logic, then what's that telling us? Let's see, what else do we have in here? Queen of Swords, oh wait, it's got the Emperor, the Empress, the High Priestess. Alright, hold on. Queen of Swords, okay. Here we go, Queen of Swords. Think you're kicking her out of her double wide, you've got another thing coming. Underneath her hair curlers and terry cloth bathrobe beats the heart of a true fighter. The Queen of Swords represents a woman who may have suffered the loss of a loved one, but still carries on. She's a little tougher, a little wiser, and definitely ready for the next wave of terror. Also says here, intelligence, sharp tongue, unscrupulous. So, in your past, as a woman, so this represents a woman who suffered the loss of a loved one, but still carries on. Okay. The Knight of Swords. This is the present. This is the warrior of the tarot. The Knight of Swords rushes in and doesn't necessarily worry about details. Who cares if a few innocent bystanders are squished along the way? Cunning, cocksure, and strategic, this knight won't let anyone stop him. His enthusiasm for getting the job done will leave you breathless. But don't be surprised if you find yourself cleaning up the carnage. Brave, ego, lack of emotion. So this is you in the present. Maybe somebody you know, I guess, perhaps. This is quite complicated to get the full, gist. Let's see, let's go back to the beginning. It says the Knight of Swords. So it's a real person in the present. And it's a real person in the present that's brave. No emotion, very egotistical. So the past is a real person that suffered the loss of a loved one. Now we have someone that's brave. Lacking emotion, though. Very go-getting, go-getter. Very not worried about. Very cunning. Doesn't care too much about people. And is just gonna go get it, and not really care about people or anything. And this is the future. Page of Swords. He may always have his nose in a book. But you can bet he's mapped out an effective escape route. Intelligent, thoughtful, and curious, the Page of Swords represents a young person in or about to enter your life. He's not afraid to ask a lot of questions. He will help you get all the facts before you make an important decision. So if this was your reading that I'm doing for you, now this represents someone in your past, perhaps you, someone that survived the loss of a loved one. This is someone you know, or you today, that is out, very egotistical, is out for blood, so to speak. Like I said here, brave, no emotion, not worried about hurting people along the way. And in the future, someone's gonna come into your life, a young person is gonna come. child. Maybe that's, you know, who knows, someone else's child. And they're going to help you with an important decision. I love this stuff because even though it's really random and fake, it's sometimes it's funny, you know. If you're a person that likes always looking for meaning, susceptible like I am to reading too much into this stuff, that, you know, it's kind of cool. So, so it's interesting. Let's do that again. And I'm not even really in the mood to eat or drink, so not after that beer. So hopefully you're just nice and relaxed. And maybe you've already dozed off or ready to doze off. Let's do another reading here. Solitude, respite, and self-reliance. So let's learn about your past. We all need some time to ourselves. Just because you hear the undead knocking doesn't mean you need to open the door. A much-needed break helps you to recharge before heading back out into the ruckus of the zombie apocalypse. Take a few deep breaths before you open that door. What's that smell? The odor of power, my friend. And the pile of corpses in the backyard. So your past. We'll go back to the beginning again. Let's see what it says about the past. Doesn't really say anything. Okay, that's the major arcana. Okay. So the major arcana is chronicles a fool's journey from his first faltering steps to the end of the world. So your past was the hermit. Your past was full of solitude, respite, and self-reliance. And your present is the hanged man. The hanged man has sacrificed himself, distracting the zombies so that his friends might live to fight another day. But not every sacrifice is necessarily terminal. There's a good chance you've arrived at an epiphany that will allow you to continue on your path. It's time to discard old ideas and move on. Often, this is the only way to set yourself free. So right now, in your present life, you are the hanged man. You are at a turning point. Acceptance of a situation and sacrifice. So let me know if, you know, we'll think about that. That really relates to anything going on right now in your life. And then your future is the Wheel of Fortune. Luck, fate, and destiny. Just, it's kind of saying right now, just to go with the flow store for you. Just let it come. So it's all about luck, fate, and destiny in your future. So, you know, think about that. That really, you know, seems to fit you and what you think's coming your way. Alright, let's see. We have the broken heart. If you're nursing the pain of a broken heart, so this is a spread that will talk about relationship, I guess, or troubled relationship, the gravestone. Important issue. This will deal with an important issue in your life. The eyeball. The eyeball is, okay, the month ahead. Previous month, overview of the current month, the first week, second week, third week, fourth week, and possibilities for the next month. Then we have the severed head. And this is about the primary issue in your life, the past, distant past, recent past, present, immediate future, factors that will affect the outcome of the issue, and this card represents the outcome. Even with a good head on your shoulders, it's still hard to get a complete look at your surroundings. Severing the head solves the issue nicely, allowing for a 360 perspective on a situation. So, the severed head, this is about getting perspective on a particular situation. So it's the primary issue in your life. Let's do that. Let's do the severed head. And this will be the last one, I think. And then if you're still with me, if you haven't fallen asleep, or if you haven't run off in boredom, let me know if this is something that you'd like to do. You know, I plan on doing it anyway. Maybe I can do a live session, a live Google Hangout. These cards aren't getting shuffled, but you know, it doesn't really matter because you could shuffle them 100 times and they can end up in the same place before you shuffle them, so although it's not likely the case, but I think you know what I mean. So, alright, let's cut that deck. Let's do this spread, the severed head. We got one. Some things are out of your hands, but you'd be silly to leave your fate to chance. You control more of your destiny than you think. Luck, fate, and destiny. So right now, whatever that primary issue is, that's what that speaks to. Alright, so this card here, the two card, this represents the distant past. Distant past, the hangman. And what did we say the hangman was? Represents a turning point, acceptance of a situation, sacrifice. So it's a good chance you've arrived at an epiphany that will allow you to continue on your path. It's time to discard old ideas and move on. Often this is the only way to set yourself free. So to get perspective on whatever this primary issue is in your life, the distant past talks about a turning point. Acceptance of a situation and sacrifice. Discarding old ideas and moving on. So maybe the this might give you perspective on your primary issue. I don't really know. I'm just winging it here. 3. This is the recent past. The hermit. And what did we say the hermit was? The hermit. Going the wrong way, I think. So the recent past, you know? Again, it's solitude, respite, self-reliance. Talking about taking a much-needed break before heading out, back out in the ruckus of everyday life. Take a few deep breaths before you open that door. Sometimes we need time for ourselves. So taking a break from your recent past, perhaps. Solitude from your recent past. Respite, self-reliance. So, four right here. This represents the present. The 8 of hazards. That's the present. Invention, ingenuity. Hazards demonstrates the need to think outside the pressurized expansion tank. If a current endeavor is failing or stalling, try rewiring the brain to explore new possibilities in different angles. Don't return to the same tactics over and over. You need to put your talents and imagination to better use. So whatever that issue is, the present talks about, you know, a new approach to that issue, perhaps. Invention, ingenuity. Don't rely on the same tactics. So, let's get back to that spread. Let's see what we got. Alright, we got 5. The immediate future. The 7 of hazards. So the immediate future, you know, next week, next month, maybe. Test subjects are improving and your persistence will soon pay off. This current endeavor is still in progress, but you're pleased with the results so far. The only thing left to do is wait and keep the doors bolted. Through careful planning, you'll soon reach the light at the end of the tunnel. So it's whatever's going on, maybe with this issue and the near future, be patient. You know, you're going to progress and you'll gain something. So, I'm not sure if a lot of these kind of contradict each other, but it is what it is. It's random, you know? It's just kind of like random advice, I guess. Alright, we have 6. This is factors that will affect the outcome of the issue. So whatever your main issue is, these are factors that will affect the outcome. 6 of hazards. What we got here? 6 of hazards. Generosity, favors, and rewards. Gifts are coming your way, but be wary of any strings that might be attached. Someone may be trying to buy your love or allegiance. Read the fine print before accepting assistance from others. Are they looking out for your own interests, or do they expect something in return? So that will affect the outcome of this issue. People are coming your way. With gifts, people looking for favors and generous, so beware of something like that, I guess. Apparently it's going to affect the outcome of whatever that issue is in your life. Lastly, the outcome. So this will be the outcome of whatever that issue is in your life. 4 of hazards, another hazards card. Need to shuffle better. 4 of hazards, the outcome is selfishness, hoarding, and possessiveness. You've got a fully stocked underground bunker with enough provisions to last for months, but why hoard them all for yourself? Don't you hear new friends and possible loved ones banging on the door? The 4 of hazards encourages you to abandon tired ideas or relationships. Embrace change for the better. Unlock the door and share some canned ravioli with a new friend. So the outcome of this issue is that you should embrace change, open the door, look for new relationships and ideas, get rid of tired ones, new friends and things like that. So, pretty interesting. Like I said, I'm just new with this, so that's kind of take, it's kind of an interesting way of giving advice. Just random shuffling of cards, and is there something here that maybe you never thought about? You know, that's really what it is. It's not that this is the answer, but it's more about, have you thought about this? Here's your issue. Have you thought about all these different things from your past, your future, things that will affect it, and things that maybe you think about that might, how will turn out, things like that. So, all right, well, thank you for joining me. Again, let me know what you think. I'll definitely be doing one of these with Frank Walker, the undead zombie. Doing a tarot reading with him, but I got more videos ahead of him. So, all right, again, thank you. Take care of yourself. And get your sleep, get your rest. Until next time.